Hey everyone, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. It's Roadshow edition for us, and something even more exciting is happening this week than Chipstock Investor Roadshow. Hard to believe, but CES is happening.
Yeah, and of course, NVIDIA is there. I actually remember the day when CES was consumer electronics and like new console releases for video games was kind of the thing that you tuned in for. Now it's basically just NVIDIA's show. And we got a new Jensen leather jacket. Or was it a leather jacket? I don't know what this thing was, Casey.
I don't know, but he made some jokes about it to the audience at the beginning of his keynote. We'll let you just preview them right here.
Are you excited to be in Las Vegas? Do you like my jacket? I thought I'd go the other way from Gary Shapiro. I'm in Las Vegas after all. If this doesn't work out, if all of you object, well, just get used to it. I really think you have to let this sink in. In another hour or so, you're going to feel good about it.
I don't know, Nick. Is that an alligator skin jacket?
You'd know better than me.
I think my dad had boots of that same material. Cowboy boots made out of that same material.
Well, Jensen was right. It's appropriate for Las Vegas either way.
Absolutely. Okay, let's get down to business. Today, we're going to just focus on one portion of the keynote address from Jensen Huang and some of the releases that NVIDIA had at the CES event yesterday. And before we talk about that, I want you to take a look back at this video from August. We'll link it here and we'll put it in the description if you haven't seen it yet. The video is titled NVIDIA's Next AI Hit, and we focused on these two segments right here, gaming and professional visualization. Before we continue, quick word from the sponsor of today's video, finchat.io.
By now you probably recognize the visuals from FinChat, like this one that we're going to talk about right now about NVIDIA's different revenue segments. For this video, we have the gaming segment and the professional visualization revenue segment selected on FinChat. Great way to visualize and get better understanding of how businesses make money and why, because there are actually some AI features baked into FinChat as well, right?
Yes, they have an awesome copilot feature where you can ask the copilot just about anything you want, and it'll give you sourced information from maybe recent earnings call transcripts or quarterly announcements, gives you the information that you need to make the best investing decisions for your portfolio. And you can get 15% off any paid plan with our link in the description, finchat.io/CSI.
In the description below, finchat.io/CSI gets you that 15% off any paid subscription. Gaming and then later on ProViz are NVIDIA's roots. This is where they got started in PC video game graphics, and then eventually professional graphics, which could be anything from the movie industry doing video rendering for scenes or engineering and architectural work, so on and so forth. And the last peak for these two segments was about $4.2 billion in the spring of 2022. So in the wake of the pandemic, we had that massive surge in consumer spending on PCs and laptops when everybody was stuck at home. And for a while, it seemed like the whole world was going digital and wasn't going to be anything else. And then, of course, then we had the bear market. But thanks to two things, we think that these two segments for PCs and laptops are going to reach new all-time highs in 2025 and 2026. We think revenue combined for gaming and ProViz will sail through $5 billion quarterly. And the first reason why, we are at the start of a new growth cycle for consumer electronics. There is a new growth cycle that was a bit lackluster last year. Some of that growth may be getting pushed out into 2025 and 2026. The whole AI PC thing didn't land with consumers like the semiconductor market expected it would or hoped that it would. So we are still, in our opinion, at the start of a new growth cycle for consumer electronics, which is the theme of that big show in Las Vegas, right?
Yes. It was very exciting. NVIDIA announced the release of the RTX 50 series for PCs and laptops. This 50 series is going to provide 2x the performance of the 40 series, which is already pretty incredible.
Yeah, it really is. You're rocking a 4070, so you are way out of date already. but you've gotten some good use out of it already. This 50 series actually has been delayed in that video Casey mentioned back in August. Historically, the new graphics cards for PCs and laptops tend to get announced by Nvidia in the fall. They delayed it, of course, to January for CES and a lot of new hardware features. Yet they showed us some of the Blackwell chip architecture that goes into the actual GPU chip itself. In the RTX 50 series, you can see that clip here.
Yeah, this thing is an absolute monster. You can see Jensen holding it here in this clip. The new 50 series GPU cluster. I don't
need endpoint node.
Yeah, it's huge. But this will be for PCs only, and that'll be out in January. You can see that in the announcement here, the 5090 GPU and the RTX 5080 GPU will be available in January 30th at almost $2,000 and almost $1,000 respectively. They also have some other models, the RTX 5070, starting at $550, which is super cheap. You can see that the RTX 4090 was nearly $1,600 when it first came out. Now there will be GPUs that are available that are much faster than the 40 series for a fraction of the cost.
Yeah, basically the same performance as that 40 high-end 40 series. There was a lot of worry about these things when they unveiled the 50 RTX 50 series breaking the bank. That was the big concern with the 40 series a few years ago when those were first unveiled. But NVIDIA, it looks like, going back to the drawing board here and doing right by some of its loyal customers and not implementing massive price hikes on these. Even though you could probably make the argument, inflation is a real thing with these really big GPU chips that are going into these things now. But yeah.
Jensen did say multiple times that the reason that they can offer these at such a reasonable price in comparison is AI. They're using their own cooking.
Yeah, and we'll be talking more about that in upcoming videos later this month when we do a breakdown of the EDA sub-industry of semiconductors, EDA software for design work, and then of course IP and patents, which we will round out this video with talking about briefly.
And one quick final note on the laptop release, they'll be out in March. So all of you laptop users that are maybe holding out, it's coming.
If you do use these things on the road without a plug-in, I would probably venture to say you're going to need a mobile battery pack to go with it. Someone mentioned we should probably get a sponsorship from one of those mobile battery pack manufacturers. No one's come knocking yet though. So yeah, if you're watching and you represent one of those companies, hit us up.
Yeah, battery life is a real problem in all PCs. Except Apple, and I don't want to hear it. Please don't comment and tell me about Apple MacBooks. I already know.
Stassi, Casey doesn't want to hear it. That's for you.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it from anyone, actually.
Okay, let's move on to announcement number two that we're focusing on today.
Okay, this is important because this is what is bringing AI to your personal computer. Now, we're not talking about ChatGPT or Gemini. This is a little bit different than that. NIMs or NVIDIA Inference Microservices and AI blueprints on those RTX PCs.
And of course, it has to be the RTX 50 series. At least at this point anyways, these are only going to be supported by the RTX 50 series. And that makes sense. What NVIDIA is doing here is pulling some of these foundational models that have been getting trained in data centers and pulling the inference of those large foundational models out of the data center and onto your personal device. These models can be quite large, so it makes sense that at least for starters, they would only be rolling these out on the new RTX 50 series GPU, getting a lot of users to upgrade. I would venture to say that's one reason for it, but also just the fact that there are a lot of operations that need to be performed on these things to inference some of these AI models locally on your device. And what's really exciting about this, the last highlight on the press release when NVIDIA announced this, is the new wave of low-code and no-code tools that are coming to market thanks to large language models, a new batch of machine learning, and all things AI. The ability to inference these now, shrink the models down so that they can fit on a PC or a laptop, is bringing the ability to perhaps do some development on device. So that's great if you're a developer, but maybe you don't know how to code, or maybe your understanding of coding is limited. This has really always been the vision for NVIDIA. Jensen's been talking about this for years, wanting to make software coding an obsolete skill set for most people. Democratizing, I guess you could say, the ability to create applications that are tailor-made for you, of course, using NVIDIA hardware and now inference software directly on the device.
What exactly are we talking about when we say NIM or NVIDIA Inference Microservices? What is that?
So all of this goes back into all of the work that has been going on in the data center the last couple of years, all that AI that has been getting trained on massive amounts of data. But now that these models are trained, lots of fine tuning is being done to them. The models are getting shrunk down to a point where they can actually fit onto a PC. What used to take place in the data center after training was inference. And to keep it really simple, I think just about everybody has probably interacted with an AI chatbot at this point. Inference is when you ask the AI to do something. So for example, maybe you ask ChatGPT a question and it comes back to you with an answer. That's inference. That's what we're talking about here. Just new computing terminology in this new era of AI. So what NVIDIA has done is they've taken these inference models and shrunk them down onto these new RTX 50 series PCs and laptops.
Okay, let's talk about the third announcement, Project Digits personal computer. This thing looks high tech.
Yeah, this thing is really high tech, Casey. This is different, separate announcement from the RTX 50 series graphics cards and ProViz cards, because this is actually powered by a GB10 or Grace Blackwell 10 GPU, essentially a miniaturized version of the Grace Blackwell superchips that are going into all those really high powered servers in data centers. Again, they've done is they've shrunk this down and fit it into something that goes on your desktop. So this begs the question, Casey, what in the world would someone need a miniature data center server for on their desktop?
Well, I'll definitely need it. This would be amazing for looking at Pinterest.
I had a feeling you'd say that. And
like, you know, looking up recipes, I don't know.
Yeah, you can do whatever you want with this thing.
Dog videos. Just all the cool stuff. But actually, this $3,000 computer will actually be for the workplace, for developers, for creatives, people that can actually utilize these tools to their proper degree, or for the rest of us to look at dog videos.
Yeah. A petaflop of AI computing, 1,000 times more powerful than your average PC. This can do some serious work. Lots of use cases here. And again, this hardware and software combination is just NVIDIA's obvious hope is going to get more PC users incentive to upgrade and maybe finally push the market back into growth mode again.
Yes, absolutely. You can see that from these two slides that we showed you earlier. First, you can see that there has been an increase in professional visualization and gaming revenue for NVIDIA, but it hasn't been quite the same growth rate that it has been in the past, but maybe 2025 is the year. Maybe this is the year where they could reach all-time highs in this category.
Yeah, and our baseline expectation at this point is these two segments together, let's call this PC in totality, not just gaming and ProViz, we'll just say all things PC for NVIDIA, reachieves all-time high sales. And our baseline expectation is it goes through $5 billion in quarterly revenue and beyond late this year.
Jensen is certainly feeling like a superhero. NVIDIA is definitely ruling this industry in a lot of ways and driving the market. And beyond fabless chip designer, NVIDIA falls into these three other categories. They have lots of intellectual property, and they're also trickling down into software and tech equipment and devices.
Yeah, this is really the power of vertical integration. NVIDIA has vertically integrated across the entire right-hand side of the semiconductor industry flow at this point. And it's the secret as to why it has become some sort of quasi-monopoly in this era of AI, and why it is just going to be close to impossible, in our opinion, for anybody to just simply catch up to what NVIDIA is doing at this point. Okay, last slide. We shared this with you back in November. our updated outlook and baseline assumptions for NVIDIA this coming year, calendar year 2025, which mostly corresponds with fiscal year 2026 for NVIDIA.
Yeah, our base case now assumes revenue of around $200 billion for fiscal year 2026. That'll be this calendar year, 2025. And we're assuming that the Hopper system sales continue, low double-digit percentage growth in networking, incremental addition of Blackwell, more GPUs, plus higher average selling price compared to the Hopper, and double-digit percentage growth in gaming and ProViz, which we just talked about in this episode. This also assumes $100 billion in operating income, and currently the stock is trading for around 36 to 42x, our base expectation for next year's GAAP net income. And if you haven't seen it yet, we did review all of our top picks for 2024. We said that NVIDIA is our largest position. It's our largest chip stock position and largest position overall in our portfolio. We're holding on to our NVIDIA and we don't have any plans to change anything.
Yeah, that's right. So stay tuned for more updates. If you want more coverage on CES from us and what this means for NVIDIA and the whole AI and semiconductor ecosystem at large, join us on Semiconductor Insider, just 10 bucks a month. Link to that in the description below. What we didn't talk about today is all the robotics announcements that NVIDIA made. We're compartmentalizing these two things. We have PC, which comprises gaming and professional visualization, and then robotics, which includes automotive. And what a lot of investors are hoping for is some sort of iteration of a humanoid robot in the coming years. We're separating those two things as two different segments at this point. Join us for more coverage on that at Semi Insider, and we'll have more videos coming for you later on this weekend.
Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, like the video, and share with your friends. We'll see you all again very soon at Chipstock Investor. You'll see a lot of their charts. If you want to analyze like us, you can get a... Okay.
Just start over.
She's like licking my face.